The following is a class on the Bhagavad Gita as it is, 7th chapter, text number 9 and 10, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded on February 24, 1974, in Bombay, India.
Translation: I am the original fragrance of the earth, and I am the heat and fire. I am the life of all that lives, and I am the penances of all ascetics. O son of Pitha, know that I am the original seed of all existences, the intelligence of the intelligent, and the prowess of all powerful men.
Punnaganda prithivyansha tejasvasmi vibhavaso jivanam sarvabhutesu tapaschasmi tapasyasu. Punnaganda, it may be original, also the fragrant. Just like there are some flowers like rose, the fragrance is very nice. Of course, all fragrance is varieties, but Prithivyamsha, the fragrance is coming from the earth. It is not synthetic fragrance. So, the same earth, the same watering, the same, what is called, sar, for growing the trees, manure. The same manure, same water, the same gardener, but according to different flowers, the fragrance is different. How this is done? Can any scientist answer? How it is coming? Different. And why there are different? If it is nature, then the ingredients are the same. Why nature is not producing the same quality or the same kind of flower or trees or fruits? Why? Therefore, it is answered in the Bhagavad Gita that nature is not all in all. Nature cannot work independent. Nature is in material world, material elements. So, it is answered there in the Bhagavad Gita. Maya dhaksena prakriti syate sacharasaram. There is superintendence of the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Krishna. He likes that this kind of bija or the seed will produce this kind of flower and this kind of flavor. The superintendence is there of the Supreme Personality of Godhead. We fools, we say, we cannot explain. We say, nature. What is this nature? There must be brain behind the nature. Otherwise, how a rose so nicely it is coming? Even from artistic point of view, if you want to paint one flower, you have to take so much labor, so many colors, reflection and so many instruments, then hardly you can paint one nice rose flower. Still it is not as good and not at all good in comparison to the original flower. So in this third class flower, you have to apply so much brain, and this first class flower has no brain behind it. Is that very good logic? What is this logic? There must be brain. And that is stated here. Punnaganda prithivyamcha tejaschasmi vibhavaso. Aam. It is my under my superintendent. So Krishna is giving us intelligence that if you do not go to the temple or do not hear to the Acharya, you can at least try to understand my presence when you see a flower or smell a flower. Is that very difficult job? Krishna consciousness is so nice. Even drinking water, even by seeing the sunshine, even by seeing the moonshine, or if you are a Vedic scholar, by chanting Om, Pranavas Sarvabhidishu, or even by hearing the sound, vibration, or by seeing a flower, or smelling a flower, something brilliant, just like the sun is brilliant, the moon is brilliant, Jesus cosmic. So where from this brilliance come? The brilliance is imitation and reflection of the bodily brilliance of Krishna. That is stated in the Brahma Sutra, Brahma Sangita. Jasya prabha prabhavato jagadanna koti. Then why we should disbelieve? We can see eye to eye that the sun is so brilliant. It is a material product only. But where from the sun has come so brilliant? Just chakshus resa savita sakalat grahana raja samastamu samastha suramurti asesa teja. The brilliance and the temperature is unlimited. So where from the brilliance come? You can calculate yourself that the sun is composition of these chemicals, this material, but why don't you produce? Why don't you produce an imitation sun so that you will save so much money for electricity? At night you can get one sun in Bombay city. So the rascals will give all description, but they will never be prepared to prepare it, to manufacture it. Recently, it is a practical in California, one learned chemical scholar, he has got Nobel Prize. So he was describing that from matter, life has come. So there was one student, he is my disciple, Sarup Damodar. He questioned, "Sir, if I give you all these chemicals, can you produce life?" Then he said, "That I cannot say. But if you know that this chemical composes life, so when I give you the chemicals, why don't you produce?" So simply theorize. Simply theorizing, panthastu koti satavatsa sampragamma. So we cannot decide by theorizing. But if we take shelter of Krishna, here is the perfect knowledge. It's like if you have to paint one flower, or if you have to create some scent, you have to mix so many chemicals. But he is so powerful, his energies are so perfect. The sabhavik jnana valak kriyasa, simply by his willing, immediately everything is there. Parasya sakti vividhaivasya. That is the appreciation of the energy of God. If you are not appreciating, that is your fault. But there is brain, there is word. But the energy is so perfect. Just like nowadays electronic energy. You simply push on one button and so many things happen to you. It is still 100,000 times subtler. Simply by his willing, everything. This is understand. But because you have no such brain, neither we can think, we evade the issue. Therefore, if we want to understand how this power has come in, how this fragrance is there, you try to understand that it is due to Krishna. And appreciate. That is Krishna consciousness. You appreciate. Oh, my Lord is so There is a story, I said. It is not story. I take it as story. That sometimes Narad Muni was passing, and one very learned scholar Brahmin, he saw Narad Muni. And he asked Narad Muni, "Sir, where you are going?" He said, "I am going to Vrindavan, Vaikuntha, to see my Lord." "Oh, you are going there?" "Narad Guru has got free passes to everyone. So, will you ask Narayan when my liberation will come?" "All right, I shall ask." And then he met another cobbler. He was sewing shoes. So he also asked, "Sir, where you are going?" "Now I am going to Vaikuntha to see my Lord. So, will you ask when I shall get salvation?" So, Narad Muni noted, "All right, I shall ask." So when Narad Muni met Narayan, he, after finishing his business, he asked the two men to stand. That these two men, one very learned scholar Brahmin, he also asked me this question, and the cobbler also asked. So, Narayan said, "This cobbler will get his salvation after finishing this life. And this Brahmin will have to wait for many, many births." So Narad Muni became very much inquisitive. "How is that?" So when he came back, first of all he met the Brahmin. He inquired, "Did you inquire, sir, about me?" "Yes, yes." "He said that he will have to wait many, many births." "No, he did not say many, many births." Krishna said, Narayan said, "Then when you meet them again, you say that if they inquire what my Lord was doing at that time, you say that he was pulling one elephant from the hole of a nail." What is it called? Lidl. So, when he met the Brahmin, he said, and he inquired what Narayan was doing when he met him, "I saw that he was pulling one elephant through the hole of a needle." Oh. See, immediately, "All right, sir, namaskar. Here all these big, big stories we cannot believe. That an elephant is being drawn through the hole of a needle." And the same question was raised by the cobbler. And Narad Muni replied in the same way. And he began to cry. "Oh, my Lord is so powerful. He can do anything." So Narad Muni inquired that, "How do you believe that the elephant is being drawn through the hole of a needle?" "No, why not? I am seeing daily. I am sitting under this banyan tree and there is fig, banyan fruit. And there are thousands of seeds, and I know that each seed is containing a big tree like this." And that's a fact, everyone knows. Bijoham sarva bhutanam. Here Krishna says, Bijoham sarva bhutanam. Is there any chemist just get one a small seed, like the fig seed? It is very small, but it contains that big tree. Where is that chemistry? Where is that physics? So here is the answer. Krishna says, Bijangamang sarva bhutanang vidhi. Even this big gigantic universe, that is also Bijangamang sarva bhutanang. It is stated in the Vedic literature. Jasaita nishasita kalama thavalamba jivanti loma vilaja jagadanna natha. There are so many things. Everyone is inquisitive. Where is the beginning of this thing? The beginning is the Supreme Law. That is the Vedanta Sutra. Janmadasya jataha. Beginning is there. So you cannot say that life has come from matter. That is not possible. Because here it is said, Krishna says that Bijanaman Sarvabhutana, anything which has come into existence, the original source is Krishna. The Krishna is life, is not dead stone. Therefore, the conclusion is, from life has come and matter has come. Not that matter has come from life. What is that? Life has come from matter. That is not the conclusion. That is wrong conclusion. So, if you actually require perfect knowledge, then we have to accept knowledge like this way. It is called Arohapantha. Arohapantha means descendance or deductive process. So our Krishna consciousness movement, we claim that we have got perfect knowledge of everything because we are taking knowledge from the perfect person, Krishna. Evaṁ parampara prātam imaṁ rājasayo vidu. And that is the real process. If you simply speculate to arrive at the conclusion, inductive process, just like if you want to study whether man is mortal or immortal, there are two processes. Deductive process, you take the idea from superior person, the man is mortal. If you accept, then your knowledge is perfect. But if you want to approach the knowledge by inductive process, by studying each man, whether he is mortal or immortal, you may study 1,000, 2,000, 5,000, but you cannot study all the men. Therefore your conclusion remains always defective. You cannot do that. Therefore, the best process is knowledge, is to receive from the person who is authorized. Actually do that. We go to school, we go to college to receive knowledge from the superior person. That is our process. That is perfect knowledge. You cannot manufacture knowledge. Therefore, real knowledge of everything can be had from the Bhagavad Gita. If you study it nicely, it is very easier and perfect. Vijagmāna sarva-bhūtāna Vidhi Pātha Sanātana. Sanātana. Sanātana means eternal. It is not that beast that which is produced and again it is vanquished. Sanātana. In another place Krishna says, Aham Bija Padapita. The all living entities, Sarva Jonishu Kauntya Sammamanti Murta. Tāsāṁ mahajjani brahma aham abhīja puja. Aham, the person. He is just like the father gives the seed in the womb of the mother and the child comes up. Similarly, sarva-bhūtāna, not only human being, but also all living entities. There are 8,400,000 species of living entities. The original bīja, the seed-giving father is Krishna. Therefore, Krishna is international or inter-universal. Krishna is not a Hindu or Indian or this or that. Krishna is for everyone. So, I have explained to my foreign students, America, European and Africa and other, that Krishna is for everyone. Don't take it that Krishna is for the Hindus, for the Indians, or for the Brahmins or the Kshatriyas. No. Krishna is for everyone. Therefore, our society's name is Krishna Consciousness. So our only request is that take Krishna as the original father. It is very easy to understand. As I have got my father has got father, his father, his father. Who is the original father? The original father is Krishna. Aham abhijak padapita. So where is the difficulty to understand? There must be one original father. If you go on researching who is the original father, then you will come to the conclusion that Krishna is the original father. Ishara Parama Krishna Satchidananda Vigraha Anadi Radi Govinda Sarvakarana Karana. This is the Vedic Bhagavad. Sarvakarana Karana. Father's father, his father, his father. Go on, go on. You come to Brahma. Brahma is considered the forefather or grandfather. Pitamaha. But Krishna is addressed in the Bhagavad Gita. Prapitamaha. Even the father of Brahma. Prapitamaha. We'll find in the 11th chapter. Prapitamaha. His father of. Tene Brahma Rida Adikabaya. You know, those who are conversant with the Shastras, that Brahma's another name is Swayambhu. He is not born of any material father and mother. He is born on the lotus flower sprouted from the navel of Mahavishnu, Garbhodak Sai Vishnu. Therefore, his name is Swayambhu. Swayambhu is one of the authorities. Because he was first educated about the Vedic knowledge by Krishna or Vishnu. Tene Brahma Rida. Brahma means Vedic knowledge. Tene means imparted. Adikavaya, the Adikavi, the original person. Tene Brahma Rida Adikavaya. Muihanti Jatsuraya. Even big personalities, they become bewildered to understand Krishna. Therefore Krishna says, we have already discussed, manusyanam sahasreshu kasti jatati siddhaya jatatam visiddhyanam kasti vetimam tattak. So Krishna is the supreme person. Krishna is the original of everything. Original source of everything. That is the Bhadi Kavi. And therefore Arjuna accepted sarvametamritangamanne jadvadasi kesa. My dear Krishna, whatever you are saying, I accept him, accept all these in total, not deducting, not giving my own commentation. This is the way of studying Bhagavad Gita. So if you study Bhagavad Gita as it is said in this, and if you accept it, then your life is successful. Otherwise, panthasu koti satavatsa sampragamma vayurathapi manasu munipangavana. You'll never understand what is God or what is ultimate source or what is absolute truth. So, the Bhagavad Gita is the essence of all Vedic literature. Because after all, Vedic literature means Veda ista sarvari aham eva vedam. To understand Krishna, the absolute truth, the supreme personality of Godhead. That is the purpose of Vedic study. So, the supreme personality himself is giving the knowledge of the Supreme by himself, personally. Therefore, we are preaching this Bhagavad Gita as it is, Krishna consciousness, and the easiest method is to chant Krishna's name. Easiest means. It is recommended, it is not our manufacture. It is said. When Maharaj Parikshit learned all the defects of this Kali Yuga, then he was little disappointed how this man or the person, man means human being, how they will be relieved from the miserable condition of materialistic life in this age of Kali. Because it is all defective. Now it is stated in that chapter that in the Kali Yuga, the mlecha rajanna rupina bhakkhai shanti prajasarve. The government will be all mlechas, not the khatriyas. Mlechas. Mlecha rajanna rupina. They will take the post of government for government service. And their business will be bhakkhai shanti prajasarve. They will devour all the prajas. And in this way, the prajas will be so much, distressed. That gacchanti girikananam. Gacchanti girikananam. They will be so much harassed that they will give up their home and heart and go to the forest. That time is coming. It is no more that Brahman, Kshatriya, Vaishya. That was human civilization. There is no human civilization if there is no such division as Brahman, Kshatriya, Vaishya, Shudra. That is not human, that is animal civilization. Chaturvarnam maya system. You know, everything is there. Social, political, economical, all solutions are there in the Bhagavad Gita. But unfortunately, it is our property. It was spoken in India, and it was deserved that all Indians should learn it and spread the knowledge all over the world. The rascals are doing nothing. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Bharat Bhumite Manushya Janma Hila Jaya. It is for the perfect human. Janma Sarthak Kari Karo Paropaka. The other parts of the world are in darkness. So there is great necessity of spreading the knowledge of Bhagavad Gita all over the world. The customers are also ready. So if you want glory of India, if you want to glorify your life, just study Bhagavad Gita as it is and spread it all over. You'll be honored. Single-handed whatever I have done, they are thinking wonderful. And if we have got many, many persons to go outside India and preach this gospel of Bhagavad Gita, they will be benefited and you will be glorified. Your country will be glorified. This message of Bhagavad Gita. It is a fact. It is not a story. People are fed up with this wrong type of civilization. This is not civilization. Ahara nidra bhaya maithansa. Day and night. This is also warned in the Srimad Bhagavatam. Nunam pramatta kurute vikarma. Jadindriya pritaya prinoti. Na sadhu manne. Jato atmanayam. Asannapi kleso deyaso deha. Vishabde has said, but these rascals, Pramatta. Pramatta has become mad. Nunang Pramatta. Kurute Bhikarma. Always engaged in mischievous activities. These rascals, these materialistic persons. Nunang Pramatta. They have become mad. And their business is Nunang Pramatta Kurute Bhikarma. Karma, akarma and Bhikarma. Bhikarma means activities which are forbidden in the Shastra. Just like, according to Vedic principles, at least a Brahmana, a leader, a king, should avoid these four principles of sinful activity. What is that? Meat eating, illicit sex life, gambling, and intoxication. At least this four men, who is leading the public, or he is a Brahman, or he is a king, he must be. Men must pass us. But just see what is the... Everyone, practically, they are addicted to these sinful activities. So therefore they are men, pramatya, bikarma. These are forbidden in the Shastras and they are doing that. Why? Because they are men. Why they are so mad? Nunam pramatya kurute bikarma. Not just indriya pritaye aprinoti, simply for sense gratification. Thank you very much.